Over the last 500 years, six different flags have flown over the great state of Texas. Our rich history is filled with adventure and conflict, and it captures the imagination of people all around the world, even if they've never been here. But before there were flags and countries, a proud and powerful people lived on the land that is now Texas. For European explorers, North America was a new world. For Native Americans, it was an ancient one, already filled with the stories of their lives.
Shingu is alone, was a Comanche Indian in pre-Columbian Texas. That was her name because she lost her family in a great drought when it did not rain for a very long time. Her people believed that if they made a sacrifice to the fire by burning something special, Great Spirit would bring the rain. The night was very still. The air was hot and dry. She, who was alone, brought her most precious possession to the fire, her buffalo skin doll with blue feathers in his hair.
Oh, Great Spirit, take my doll. She's very special to me. Please send the rain to save my people.
And she gently placed the doll in the fire and curled up and fell asleep. While she slept, a breeze picked up the ashes from the fire and spread them over the dry and thirsty earth. Gentle rain began to fall, drenching the land with healing water. When the sun began to rise, she woke to find the hills covered with beautiful blue flowers, the same color as the feathers from her doll's hair. Every spring, the Great Spirit remembers her sacrifice for her people and covers Texas with beautiful blue bonnets in celebration of the girl who loved her people so well.
Thank you. Texas was a part of Spain's North American Empire. Motivated by gold, glory, and God, hundreds of thousands of Spanish explorers set sail for the New World with hopes of finding riches and saving souls for God.
In the late 1600s, the land was claimed by the French when La Salle established Fort Louis. The French didn't last long, though.
Huh?
And the Spanish flag waved proudly over the land once again.
More than 200 years later, Texas was still considered a part of Mexico, which was ruled by Spain. But when Mexico gained its independence in 1821, a third flag flew proudly over Austin. As Texans longed for their independence, tensions between Texas and Mexico turned about, and the Texas Revolution began. Despite a crushing defeat at the Alamo, Texas declared its independence and soon after defeated the Mexican army at the Battle of San Jacinto.
Although Texas had declared its independence from Mexico, it was still very vulnerable to attack. Tensions flared as Texans debated whether to remain independent or join the United States. After many months of negotiation, and with the endorsement of General Sam Houston, Texas was admitted as the 28th state on December 29, 1845.
When the Civil War began, Texas seceded from the Union and joined the Confederacy. In June 1865, slavery formally ended in Texas when General Gordon Granger arrived at Galveston and announced emancipation.
The people of Texas are informed that all slaves are now free.
Texas was readmitted into the Union in 1870, and the American flag once again flew proudly over the Lone Star State.
Thank you.
The era of cotton, cattle, and railroads in the late 19th century was a time of huge economic growth for Texas. Wild longhorns were in high demand in northern states, and cowboys ignored personal danger to get their cattle safely to market. The fiercely independent cowboy and the majestic longhorn would become lasting symbols of Texas.
Landscapes have inspired the bold and adventurous for centuries. There is definitely something magical about the Lone Star State. A rich history filled with stories of courage, unwavering commitment, and a diverse culture drawn from every corner of the world.
Something about Texas just feels right.
There is no other place like Texas. Our Texas.
Under God, one and indivisible. let's give a round of applause to the dancers of 4A. Give it up for 4B. Put your hands together for 4C. Let's hear it for 4D. Give it up for 4E. Put your hands together for 4F. And don't forget the adorable tiny tots. Let's hear it for the classroom teachers. Give it up for the principal and staff of Polk Elementary. And let's rock with the Kids Excel Band. And last but not least, give it up for the Kids Excel staff. We hope you enjoyed our show, and we'll see you next time.